Toxins all right, down. So we're only about a minute into this, 30 seconds in this round, but we're starting there here. So looks like we have heavy pressure on B side here from TUW. Right now we have Sac State doing their best to defend here. They have to retake. They lost one over on B main. Oh, the retake is not going so well here. They need to group up a little bit more here, but you see everyone's playing site right now. They're one playing main, remaining. No flank, and wow. Fell down pretty quick there. They had a really fast take once they got that pick, and now they're just kind of set up.
Oh, that's sneaky.
Not much you can do here. He did sneak into this little corner here, but there's that little gap in the wall, and he got the ace. Wow. All right. There you go. What a first round.
For those who are wondering, Corona's internet decided to just die, so we had to get her a substitute. Introduce yourself, boss.
Yeah, this is my name is Jared. I play for this team, actually. I'm a substitute on this team, so it's nice to watch these guys in action here. Glad to be cast in this game. It's quite the series so far. What did that last game end up being, actually? What was it, 13 to 4. Okay, yeah, so right now we'll see how this game plays out. This is the ice box right here, so this is a very, very wide open long angle kind of map compared to Haven, which was very short angles, so it should be a different looking game here. Probably see a lot more Vandals than Phantoms. There's a lot of Phantoms on here. We'll see a lot more Vandals on this map. Right now there's heavy pressure coming towards A here from CUW. They didn't even have a flank watch actually. So we'll see if they can make anything out of this here. No, looks like they're gonna go ahead and just group up on site here. Defend the push. They got double wall right now. They got the Viper and the Harbor wall up. Okay, knife doesn't catch much here. Looks like they're gonna go for the retake here with just their pistols. Not expecting too much here. Maybe they can get a pick or two. Okay, get shot through the wall there. Good harbor wall from CUW there.
Last player standing.
Holding the harbor.
Oh wow.
Again.
Yeah, they're holding these sights down really well. Actually, they need to get more pressure, more forward here, so they don't let CUW on the site so quickly. They're just five man pushing. I mean, this is this eco round, obviously, is a complete save on Sac State, so not much you can really do there. But you can see that CUW does not have a super lot of a flank watch here. Actually, they have no flank watch, matter of fact. So hopefully Sac State ends up taking advantage of that. But we'll see here.
Take flight.
Okay, looks like this is a heavy B here. We have Sova alone on A. I think he does get darted out there since he had to destroy the dart from Sova. They're still grouping up B really hard right now. Nobody's watching B main though, so they don't know that they're there. They're walking up B main right now. We have three on A still. Looks like the Sova on CUW is going to go ahead and rotate over. Yeah, this is definitely already the B execute. They're already getting the plant down. They're not able to get the wall.
Spike planted.
Okay, and now CUW is going to hold main over here. Let's see what Sac State can do to retake this site. They got a knife, catches two. Okay, oh, they're already starting to push in here. Okay, good execute. They have the harbor level up, they got their dart, gonna mark a lot, and they're gonna clean up right now. They knew where they were. Nice. Good retake from Sac State. They really gave them no options on where to go there. They had yellow suppressed, and then they darted the back of main, so they were able to just kind of clean up that whole site. We have another full buy round going on here, so should be an entertaining round to say the least. No ults quite yet, other than the jet ult on CUW's side, but we are really, really close to getting that that Sage ult. She might try to get orb on B, and she'll be at six, and then who knows what's gonna happen.
Suppressing.
Okay, looks like we're gonna go mid-heavy here from Sac State. They really want this mid-pressure. CUW's playing a default, so we'll see. They notice that they're up here. This is a really far up, and they're gonna be pushing mid. Oh, are they gonna take more? Are they gonna go back? CUW kind of notices. Looks like they're gonna retreat after all. They create a lot of pressure there. CUW's still unsure if anybody's there. They're kind of checking it, holding that bubble, seeing what's going to happen. But two have already gone up A. They are alone, though. T. Okay, it looks like it might be an A hit here. It looks like CUW's grouping up on A. We still have bottom mid presence for Sac State here. Contact was made A. It looks like it's going to start bringing those rotates over. See if they start getting that plant. Yeah, plant's going to start going down. Quite a setup over here. They have the wall on the left, but that Sage is low and she's going to get killed by a shock dart. Oh, wow. And Silva is just cleaning up right now. They don't even get the plant down. There's still one in Nest they have to be careful of.
30 seconds left.
That was awkward. Dash right into his back. That's funny. All right, so now let's see what CUW is going to be on, an eco or a save. We'll see. Or are they going to be able to buy here? No, they're pretty broke. But we do have the Sage buying a gun, so I guess they're going to go for it. Let's see if she sells it.
What is this lineup that the KO keeps going for? How to feed? What is this lineup?
Let's see. Let's find out. It's probably going to be B main lineup here.
This is going to be a big lineup.
Yeah, we'll see how many it catches. Oh wow, what a nice op pick there.
Down B.
And that's going to get only one, actually. It looks like it was going to get all three for a second there.
Yeah.
Might have been too high.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah. All right, well, we did see... Did that Sage keep that gun after all?
It looks like
did she sell it? Okay, well, they're not going to try to recover that. It's way too dangerous because they know that op's there. So yeah, they're gonna have to save next round as well. Weird buy from CUW there, but Sac State taking full advantage.
Ooh,
Python, of it. Oh, what a spam!
The smoke.
Oh, wow. Okay, one, yeah, Sac State.
Very confident.
Yeah, very confident. So they know where he is. They know he's B main. They're all just gonna run him down here.
We're gonna start rushing.
Bowie's gonna troll, throwing a purple orb on his jet. There you go. All right. Yeah, weird buy from CUW there. I don't know why they chose to like half eco, half buy. Oh, it looks like the Sage did actually have enough money to buy. Wow. They are on a 3 loss streak, so it must be enough loss bonus there for her to be able to buy again. Are she gonna be able to have full util? Yeah, okay, yeah.
Yeah, she's gonna have full util.
She could totally buy that gun. Interesting. She's only at 150 creds. I think she did sell that gun.
She is one.
She must.
She's 1 point away from res, though.
She is 1 point away from res. Other ults on the horizon here. We got the Viper ult might come into play here. We have 3 ults on the side of Sac State. The Harbor ult will be interesting to see. Maybe they'll use it for retake. And Silva ult might be used to knife plant here.
Ooh, that was nice.
Looks like they're going to stack A. Oh, yeah. Nice knife there. See, they're going B heavy here. Oh, they're making noise now, too. Okay, so they're letting it be known. They are all B right now. Knife misses anybody. They know yellow's clear. And they're going to be taking this site here. Are they going to see the wall go down here?
That was a good Silva dart there.
It was a great Silva dart. Oh, they're going to do a dive. Oh, they're going to go for a deeper plant than usual here. Yep, that Silva ult's going to come into play, deny that plant.
Ooh,
Spike's going to go down. Sage is going to die. Great stuff. Here we go. We got Krolos on the flank here. He might be able to get something off here if they try to rotate, which they might be doing here. They are kind of stuck. The Spike's really awkward right now. They're going to drone it out here. They're going to see one player yellow. And they're going to see two main, I think. He saw both. Yeah, they are in a pickle here. CW. Oh, what a shot. Nice shot. Even the headshot. Wow.
Nice shot.
All
there
right. See, yellow remaining. Gets picked, and they know where he is. I believe the Silva saw him,
yep.
And that Krolos flank does come out through. Yeah, they're, CUW is hurting right now on the flank watch, but Sac State has a similar comp, so we'll see how the flank gets handled on Sac State's attacking side, because I'm seeing a lot of flank play able to happen here. Nobody on CUW is really watching their flank. They kind of just full commit onto one site.
It seems like they're kind of good.
Yeah.
Full commit on A here.
Yeah, we'll see if Sac State can notice that and take advantage of it, because they're totally leaving their flank open. We've seen those aggressive plays come from Sac State, actually. They went like under tube and into mid, and so we'll see if those get unnoticed next time they do that.
I do think they made a correct call here. Ooh, Jawbreaker really early on, they just cash out Krolos.
Yeah, nice pick from him.
The op is still in play, though.
Oh, he's going to get traded, though.
Missed cash out Step
Python's
Bro.
Gonna get another one. There you go. Okay, so round's going to take a little pause here. They're gonna make them uncertain if they're gonna rotate or not. That drop might signify something. I don't know if anybody heard that. They're gonna get the res off. Okay.
Yep.
Silva Dart.
They do choose to res this. Shock Dart didn't get any damage, I don't think.
It did actually. It managed to catch the. It managed to catch the Sage just barely.
Oh, it did. You're right.
Not very much though.
Okay, so they're either faking the rotate here, or they're just playing a default kind of look here. They got Silva over here droning out B. Not sure if that's gonna be a fake or. It looks like it's gonna be a fake.
I think Saxton may have been a misplay here because there is nobody on A now.
Especially. Oh yeah, and they're gonna rotate off of A here. Oh, he's staying for a little bit.
Oh,
he sees the wall go up. He stayed just long enough there. That was really lucky on him. But oh, is he gonna die? Oh, he gets one. Oh, but the Viper pit's out. Actually, we'll see if this is gonna. Oh,
Nico's
got a really good flank. He's gonna be able to get the planter. Yes.
Yeah, he did.
Nice. Okay, well we just have this Viper to deal with. 3v2 here.
The opposite still in play.
Ooh, that would have been. That was almost a collat. He doesn't die. Oh wow.
That was almost a collat there.
It was. It was really close.
That would have been
well
sick.
Played by Sac State. I mean, the fact that Spain stayed long enough for them to not be able to fake that site was huge. If he didn't notice that Viper wall in time, it would have been bad news. Yeah, CUW's gonna take a timeout here. We'll see what happens here. I'm liking the way Sac State's playing this, and we'll have to see how the other half is gonna play here. Both teams, yeah, no flank watch. Like I said earlier, it's going to be interesting here. But the flank's really not coming into play a lot from Sac State. Looks like we'll see.
I think they may be getting a little desperate here. So they're seeing the same things they saw back on Haven.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, well, looking like a. Let's see, what's the economy looking like? It's looking like it's going to have to be an eco round this round as well, so we'll see if they do a full save or if they're going to buy some, maybe a Marshal or Sheriff, Spectres. Not sure what their economy is really looking like for next round here. I don't know my bonuses offhand for loss bonuses.
They're looking pretty healthy, but not enough for them to get, like, full Vandals and armor with that. I think they're probably just gonna do SMGs.
Yeah, it looks like they're gonna do Sheriffs and Stinger. Oh, they're gonna do Stingers. Stinger meta.
Stinger's up.
We'll see how that works. Yeah, Stinger's up for them, though. Alright, so this op's gonna be sitting here on A. Early knife comes out, doesn't catch anybody. Looks like they're all going mid right now. This is an interesting play here. It is an eco round, though, so you kind of have to do something crazy, right?
But that op is in play.
Okay. All right.
They're just walking into rifles.
They're pushing up tube. Okay. Let's see what they can get out of this. The jet's already on site. Looks like they're going for a top nest plant on B, and they're going to get it off.
Planted.
Okay, now they're going to try to hold this from tube or kitchen. Well, the one's already on defuse. Nobody's really able to check this spike right now. Viper's going to have to run out in the open. Oh, wow, they get two picks off of that. Wow, that was well played by CUW. Now they collapsed on the people up in
gotta
nest.
Gotta be careful here. He has the op.
He does have the op. He's gonna have a hard time retaking this. He's such close quarter angles here. He just has to hold this box.
Yeah.
Let his teammate defuse for him. And nice kill from Ben. Wow. Well played from Sac State. They were looking like a little trouble there for a second with the Bucky and the Sheriff getting those two kills. I was a little worried. But they ended up being able to clutch it out. So we're gonna have a full buy here on both sides now. More normal round than a mid rush to kitchen.
That is, I don't even know where kitchen is on this map. So
it is where IUB is right now.
Oh,
that is kitchen. Yeah. Okay. So they were all in kitchen trying to defend the spike where
is it
the top of B nest
really is
kitchen.
As everyone could tell, I don't really play Valorant, so this is all very, very unfamiliar to me. Looks like they're going to be all rushing A here.
Yeah, this is a heavy A push. Oh, with the KO ult. Yeah, that's going to come into play here. We'll see if that deters people. We'll see if we're just going to play retake here, or it looks like we're just going to play retake. Unfortunately, he gets spammed. He'll get spammed through the smoke while trying to spam them through the smoke. Oh, but a good trade from Spain here, able to get the jet. I don't know where
Spain
she was. She was on maybe
805. Trying to clear out some of the rest of any of the fighting positions there.
It looks like CUW's gonna play this very far off site here. I don't know if that was really the move here. They have the Silva ult, or that's our Silva ult actually, wow. And they're not gonna pop their own yet. We got it half, I believe. I believe the spike was halved. Yeah, it sure was. And I don't think they're gonna be able to stop this.
And Bang catches two!
Oh no, and he pops the ult too!
Too late, he wastes the Silva ult.
I don't think they knew it was halved.
That's rough.
How unfortunate for CUW.
That is really, really rough.
They played it so far off the site. I think they were banking on that Silva ult being able to deny the plant there, but it just wasn't popped fast enough. You know, they got it half, and then once it's halved, you can't really do anything about it.
Yeah. They just had to play a bit. I think the problem with was they played it a bit too far back.
Yeah, a little too far back. They did a great job executing onto site with that KO ult, but they needed to hold a little more forward. They didn't take enough space. Sextate was able to reclaim a lot of that space really quickly once that KO ult ended. Okay, it looks like that KO knife and that Silva dart are going to come out. Default ones for Sextate here. We see a normal default here for CUW. They're just kind of poking, crowding, seeing what's happening over here. They know where the op is now. They know it's on B. It doesn't look like it's going to stop them, though. They are not deterred by that op.
I think they I think they may try to rotate A here. Actually, I think it's just Silva being a distraction. Silva gets Silva being distractions.
Silva droned out A. It's going to force out a drone from our Silva as well. It looks like they are going to move towards mid and B here. Silva's going to go down mid. We got four on B here. That op is still there, though. That op has not rotated off. So we will see if we can get a pick off of this op before the execute comes in.
I think they're just waiting.
Yeah, they are waiting. Here comes the Viper wall. Okay, they know it's a B hit now. He's going to walk through the wall. Oh, he sees the flash and he has to back off.
But Sextate does have the KO ult and a Viper pit here.
Yeah, has a KO ult, has a Viper pit. They get the spike down, and I think the wall is in the way as well. They probably just spammed it out. They're going to hold it from... Oh, okay, nice little picks going on mid here. Little trade. They three suppress on yellow.
Viper KO ult does come out.
Mm-hmm, KO ult's going to come out. They're executing this retake here. What's CUW going to do? It's Harbor orbed off. You can't shoot through that. It's just going to get off.
Harbor Orb.
Yeah, Harbor Orb's gonna protect you from that whole defuse there. Indeed. Very well played. CUW, man, they're really good at executing onto that site and getting that spike down, but they need to hold, you know?
What I'm noticing is I think they just play too passive.
Mm-hmm.
They're not playing as aggressive as they can. They initiate very well. It's just that they can't. They just play too passive. Once they aggress, it kind of feels like they kind of run out of gas.
Yeah, they have like one player playing yellow on B. I mean, B is very hard to hold on site, so you kind of do play around yellow, but they're playing like all the way back in main. I think they need to kind of move up, play maybe two on yellow instead of just the one.
Oh, it's a really early pick.
Oh, wow. Really early picks going on here. Looks like they tried going A.
Didn't seem to really work out.
Spike is down A here.
Yeah, Spike is down here.
Oh, they're going to put the Viper Spit down. Okay, it looks like that's going to turn away. They're going to go back to B here.
They did grab the Spike. There is a Vandal sitting, a Phantom sitting there, so they are down now on that.
Oh, wow, and the pick from IUB there gets off on this AX.
Only IUB
here.
Not
much
they
can do here.
That was a very nice Harbor Wall there.
Very huge pick. Looks like they're going to fake the plant out, put it in closer to the window. Almost gets killed through that wall. Very close. Spike
Harbor
down. Okay, let's see how they're gonna hold this. There's a lot of utility on Sax8's side.
Is he gonna try to use the Harbor Orb again?
Oh, and they just cleaned it up. Yeah, there you go.
I think used a little too much utility there, but it didn't really matter.
It was a little much, but their economy is so good right now. I think they can afford it. So they kind of just overwhelmed them with the utility on that retake. There's only two players. It can really only so much you can do.
Yeah. It's not really looking very good for CUW here. They are really down on cash. It looks like they're going for a buy round to try and swing this back, but Sax8...
Yeah, last round, they got to do something, you know?
Yeah.
So we'll see. Maybe their defense will be a lot better. I mean, they do have the Viper and they do have the Sage, which are pretty good agents on defense. So we'll see if that helps them out more than it will on offense.
Maybe that was the play. Maybe they were only going to focus more on defense than they were on the offense. They were trying to
Well, the Sage wall plan is very default for this map on B.
Ooh, Viper.
Oh, we have. Oh, is he gonna check? Is he? He's not gonna check. Oh,
he did not check.
But we have the jet here. Maybe it'll get a trade out. Oh, he has to run away.
Ooh.
This is the first shot. And also,
alongside Jawbreaker managed to pick on our KO as well.
Yeah. He does.
It looks like they're rotating back to A. Ooh, that was a nice cross there.
Yeah, they did rotate back to A, though, so... But wait, he's still there. They didn't check Maze.
Spain.
Huge flank. Wow.
They have
the Viper's pit down. They're going to drone him out, and that's going to be, yep.
You got to check your corners, people.
That's going to be the round, yeah. Wow, they did not check Maze at all, and Krolus was able to hide in there and get a huge flank on them. And also, Spain just cleaned up everything. He just kind of peeked out of heaven there and just got everybody. So that also works.
That's going to be this half.
Switching sides.
That is half 10-2 half here. Looking kind of grim for CUW, but I've seen stranger things happen.
Funny.
Okay, so looks like they're going to be doing, let's see, they're going to put the Sage and the Viper on B, and KO Jet's going to be on A with Sova watching mid. Okay, put Viper and Sage on B. Wow, they're really trying to hold down this B then.
They have three on A.
Almost expect
to have
Viper to be.
Three. They have two.
Mm-hmm.
They're playing kind of like very split here with the Sova and this on mid.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll see what Viper orb was put down over here on B. Okay, well, we're seeing just a B execute here from Sac State. Looks like they're going to clear out yellow. Okay, yellow's clear, and they still have this wall. They're going to get this plant down with help from the Harbor orb. See, okay, 5v5 here still. Spike down, 5v5. Let's see if CUW can get this retake off. Do we have the Sage Wall in play? Sage Wall is in play, so they have to be careful about holding from too
first
far
pick
back.
Goes out
they
to Krolus.
Can Sage Wall it off. Krolus gets the first pick on this retake. Looks like
ooh,
CUW's
there's a lot of people
here.
That Harbor Wall. A lot of people.
That Harbor Wall is really denying a lot of it.
Ooh, that was a nice sheriff there for Python. That was a nice little flank.
Uh-oh.
There. But
3v3 here. 3v3. They have the Sage Wall in 2 seconds here.
But they are suppressed. Oh, that was
dies.
A nice Molly there from Krolus.
Nice from the Molly, and wow. Yeah, Krolus coming from mid with the Sova. They were able to kind of clean it all up there.
Yeah. Really, really impressive.
Very sneaky.
Very sneaky.
Yeah.
And this is kind of dire straits for CUW, because if I'm not mistaken, this is best of three. So if they lose this map, that's it. They're done.
They got to make something happen here.
Yeah. This is quite literally the dire straits here.
Yeah, you'll notice that on Sac State's attack on B, they left Spain behind. He was mid. And that was kind of that flank watch I was talking about where CUW was just five-man executing one way. And so Sac State had free flank.
Exactly.
And they don't have any gadgets that can watch that, so...
Again, they're hard rushing
aggressive hold from this Viper with the Bucky.
Didn't really do
much. Yeah, a little too early.
And they're just gonna, they are just going to hard rush it here.
They are just gonna W key in here and get this spike down.
Yeah.
They're gonna drone out this wall too, just in case. That guy's there. He is. Free fire. Yeah. Looks like CUW. Yeah, CUW did buy this round.
Whoa! Player standing. He had a marshal. That would have been. Okay. Been nice. But
let's see if Jawbreaker can make something happen. He got the stinger. Okay, he's low health. Oh, he's marked though.
That's it.
It's gonna take a miracle at this point. They put all their marbles on that round there. They full bought everything that they could. So
I think
they're not gonna have full utility.
They might try to go final boss here, where they have one guy buy a rifle, one guy buy armor, and just try to.
They might make
one guy. I mean, one guy did buy a what is that? Bulldog, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, bulldog.
Yeah. So maybe they might go with that, but he didn't get any armor. I think that might have been the correct call to just do final boss on that.
On Jawbreaker?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, we're going to see an A execute here. Checking maze.
They're just
going to
be as aggressive as possible.
Yep, they're just going to walk in.
First pick goes out.
Get
straighted.
Traded. They're gonna get the spike down with his help of this harbor orb. Spain's gonna catch Sola out. Reloading.
Yeah. Again, they're falling back.
Wow, really far away here.
They don't have any defuse denial here.
Well, I think Spain's got a shock dart lineup. Yeah, he sure does. And he's gonna just, once he hears that tap, he's gonna throw those at him. And KO still has his Molly as well, so I think they're just gonna go for the stall here.
Yeah. There's the
there goes the shock darts.
There goes the shock darts.
Here comes the Molly.
Yep.
And here comes the Molly, and it's
there goes the Molly.
It's gonna kill her. Nope.
Okay,
she's not. And oh, the wall though. Uh-oh. No, they break it.
And that's gonna be it.
Attackers.
Wow. GG.
Good game, guys. Good game.
GG. Sac State looking dominant. Yeah, I gotta say, I think a lot of that came down to CUW not watching their flank and not holding aggressively enough on their site executes there.
Yeah, but overall, that was a great game.
Great game, yeah, great game.
Yeah, and we will be going to a short break while we sort out not only this the caster situation with if see if we're doing other stuff here, or if we get some other things coming in. We are gonna have another game here in about 30-ish minutes or so. So we'll see you guys then.
Welcome back to my internet, and for everybody else, welcome to the second half of our doubleheader. We are on Split here, and actually, I have no clue what college this is. Is this Morningside? What
This is Morningside. Yes, this is.
Morningside, whatever that is. All right, perfect. We've got Sac State. They just got off a fresh stomp, if you will, of CUW. And now they're back to, you know, do some more stompage, probably, just based off of, you know, the rankings from what we can see. But yeah, we've got Split here. Sac State are going to be attacking first, and Morningside's going to be defending. And we've got Connor working the Connor camera.
The Connor camera?
The Conra.
That's
and
I refuse to take that. Yeah, I refuse to take that term to refer to me.
No,
as...
it's the Conra.
I no, it's not the Conra.
Select your agent.
I think it is at this point. I think it's too late.
Yep.
And hopefully we're gonna see some good back and forth, but we'll see.
Who knows? We could be entirely surprised.
Very true.
Yeah, we're now back to two Overwatch casters casting Valorant. Yeah, baby. Let's go.
That's right.
Jared had to go to Costco, so it's just the two of us.
Now, the good thing about casting Valorant is there's a lot less to say, frankly.
That is very
true. Because, you know,
game kind of speaks for itself.
Yep, that's right.
Awesome. Let's keep this on going here. So let's see. I'm very intrigued to see where Sac State is going to try to push here. It seems like they're going to try and go for an A plant. What do you think, Karana?
Yeah, agreed. I mean, looks like Sac State, which is on the right side, is going towards A. That they Morningside does have some Astra util on A.
We do have a lineup here from the Viper. BU on the Viper. Let's see this lineup. Ah, I see what it's used for. It's used to cover off that flank.
Yeah, that's right. Right now it's a solo jet on A, on the A site at least. But we've got two Heaven. Now
three
it's
heavened,
three
actually.
Heaven. Okay. They know that a couple people are here. That's a big dink by somebody onto Prez World. Sage goes ahead and uses her heal. And Sac State is going to be rotating.
They're going to rotate over to B.
Though that Viper... Bui is waiting.
She's going to hear that Sky Wolf up and
up. Oh, timing!
Yep, timing. Here we go.
Almost.
And the jet is coming in to help here from top. No, she's gonna go in from bottom to help out this Viper. Again,
yeah, Sac State's gonna have bomb
one,
down on B.
Not one pick yet though, which is surprising.
No, people have been playing very cautious here. There's our
first pick.
Our second. But Prez World gets one on Krolos.
They are going to try and push in here. Sky Flash as the Jet peeks around. How did Fee manage to pick off Rose?
Jet is very low, and that's going to be Sac State taking the first one.
Round numero uno for Sac State.
And Sac State's going to go ahead and do a full armor. Sort of bonus round here.
It's Spectres. Yeah, it's Spectres.
Spectre and a Stinger.
Yep, Stinger's up.
Whereas Morningside, just gonna stick with pistols.
Don't get missing, girl.
I'm gonna save their money. This is another full A push now.
Almost missed
that jet. Almost. Bane with that dog able to show that only Jet is on the point there.
Spike planted.
How to feed plants that bomb. Ooh, but Astra's gonna be right there. Almost
Astra
timing.
Didn't. Yeah, just timing. Preswell, ooh, that was a nice headshot from Preswell on the beat.
Last player standing.
But that's probably going to be it. It's just Preswell left.
Missed a couple shots. What? Spain.
Yeah, just rush him.
Interesting. Spain flashed herself and her teammate. And...
That is an ego push, if I've ever seen
one. Yeah.
That is a complete ego push, if I've ever seen one.
Yeah, and Sac-State's gonna do another A push. I mean, it seems right now Morningside is just sort of leaving Jett alone on this A site, and Sac-State has been able to rush her every time. It looks like Jett's gonna play a little bit further back now. Jett's gonna realizes that they're being but Jett realizes that they're being pretty aggressive, but they do know where Jett is from that scout. Jett gets the first peek onto Python, but Sac-State is on their bonus. They're keeping the Spectres. So Sac-State, Morningside cannot afford to lose this one. Sac-State can afford to lose this.
Right now we're just in the battle of the peaks here.
Ooh, they know Heaven. There's at least one Heaven.
There's two Heaven, it looks like. Made helpless, and you have helpless, and I believe it's Blinks as well. Just holding out here in Heaven, here in Tower.
Again, playing very, very quiet and patient. They're kind of giving time for Morningside to rotate.
This is actually a really good Viper wall here. It's helpless, can't help his team. He is quite literally helpless to help his team.
Yeah. And Jett able to get two now. Spain goes down. Blinks got distracted by the alarm bot.
And both remaining members of Morningside are on Heaven here.
Last player standing.
Ooh, big by Bowie.
Big. Oh, almost. Unfortunate.
But that was a huge round for Sac-State. I mean, they were able to take off four guns from Morningside, which means their eco is going to be pretty shot right now. If you take a look, I mean, they can full buy, but it's gonna be tight.
It's gonna put him in the red when it comes to the eco here. Sac-State is free to just buy full rifles and armor. Well, Morningside, they have to choose whether or not to go either rifles or armor. They cannot choose both.
Yeah, and it looks like Morningside's gonna go with a half buy here.
Another Viper lineup, the same Viper lineup here. As we see these Sky ult comes out from Morningside, the first of those Sky ults. Again, they're playing incredibly quiet here. Just not. It seems like the game has really taken a step back in terms of aggression from both sides. They're really just feeling each other out, waiting to see who decides to make the first move.
Yeah, Memo does have those knives ready for Sac-State's push. Spain is going to use that scout, but is going to get slowed by the Sage. It looks like they might be rotating to A here. Krollo's able to get Press World.
That is the first pick. All that's left on B is the Viper. So I think you're right. I think Sac-State is probably going to try to go A site here.
That's an ulting Jett staring in the face of Bowie, but doesn't know that two are behind her. Spain able to get the Sage on B.
30 seconds left.
And that's a Sky ult.
Found one.
Spain knows that Viper is on B. And Sac-State's going to rotate back to B. Planting.
Python managed to catch Helpless out, who was only peeking with the isn't that the Phantom? No, it's the Phantom. What's the name of that gun again?
Which one?
The USP looking one.
Who's holding it?
Python? They were dead. They're dead now, so doesn't really matter. But
couldn't tell you.
Professional caster, ladies and gentlemen.
Now it's just a ulting Jett and a half Astra.
Last player.
They see Astra, but Jett able to get Spain. How to feed, however, cleans it up, and that's a 3-1 to Sac State.
It's looking a little rough here, but it's still really early on. But it is looking a bit rough in terms of team coordination on the side of Warning Side. It seems like that Sac State is willing to play this kind of passive style, and just waiting. It's kind of throwing Warning Side for a loop because of how aggressive they were at the start of the game.
Yeah, I mean, Morningside, if you take a look at their credits, there are several with zero credits, which means that they have less abilities as well. I mean, Morningside is... they have to win this.
And BU on the... Buoy on the Viper just wasting utility here. He's keeping both members of Morningside, two members, the Jett and the Astra, locked down here at A, so they can't help any of their teammates. We do see the Jett kind of starting to rotate here.
Ooh, Jett Buoy. Able to get Buoy there. I think Buoy, the crosshair placement was a little odd there. Krollo's very low here in mailroom. And this might be bad for Krollo's. He does get healed by Sky, and that's a big Sky flash. Krollo's able to get two there.
Blink's kept getting caught out while you're in lower connector.
Last player standing.
Yeah, now it's just a lone Jett on A again.
Yeah, memo.
Now this Jett is the only one that is in the positive for Morningside. So if there was a player that could do something here, it would be the Jett, but the ult was already used. There's not
going
to be much.
Going against four players here. One with a Killjoy too, so that's not exactly good odds. Because Killjoy can just bolt. She can just...
Krollo's
up. Yep. There we go.
Yeah, and that's going to be it.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I said earlier, that was kind of the round for Morningside. They had to win or at least take off the majority of the guns.
Oh, they're going Sheriffs.
Yeah, I mean, they have to. There's nothing much else for them to do. If they can get a few guns off of Sac State and save them, that might help, but we're already 1-4.
Mm-hmm. Let's just see if they're able to use these sheriffs effectively. We do have... They didn't manage to grab a Stinger, but there are three people at A, and there's just no one.
You should run.
And that's a B stack for Sac State. Only Viper going through heaven, but it's a lone Sage on B with a Killjoy ult and Astrowall. Sac State using a lot of ults here.
Just to get on.
And Sac State is fully on B.
They are full sending it here. And there's nothing that Morningside could do. One, the Astrowall, and two, with just the amount of utility that Sac State's used here just to get on this point.
Ooh, Memo, though, gets Buoy.
That is a Geeko ult that got denied. Fully. Unfortunate.
Ooh.
That Helpless was not able to get that Sheriff shot.
Rose was able to get a Vandal down, but gets
flash.
Caught by How to Feed.
One enemy remaining.
That was a really, really good flash there from
1v1.
This is
possible.
It is possible.
But Presworld doesn't know where Astra is.
He had a defuse there. There we go. Now we move on to the next round.
Yeah, it is looking grim.
It is looking like an A rush here. I'm sensing an A rush.
I should probably place some stars in the Astro.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like Morningside tried to do a stack, but they just picked the wrong site, which is just unlucky. I think they are best off, though, just full stacking, maybe even five stacking a site and then retaking it back, but they're not able to take these little fights.
Jett ult is popped.
Yeah, the question is whether they know that the Astra is holding very close. Python does check the corner,
but Python
gets really tagged. guy's able to tag.
Ooh, that was a nice Astra smoke there, creating that close core situation that shotgun could just eat away at him.
Yeah, but Jack is very low now. And there we go. Now it's 3v4. This is doable for Morningside. 3v2 now. Yep. Ooh, buoy.
All that's left on the site for A is actually just Prez World.
They don't know, though. I don't think.
Viper pit is
deployed. Now they do. Yeah, and that's Viper's pit out. This is going to be much harder for Morningside. That is 3, though. 3 to 1.5, essentially, with Astra so low. This is doable.
It is doable. It is winnable. But this is going to require a lot of gun skill here. It's going to require a bit of luck as well.
Ooh, Sage getting close.
Sage, ooh. Timing. Timing there from Bui. And now it's a 2v1.
Yeah. But they are both low. Astra could very... Ooh, big! Pulling them in. Ooh, that's going to be a suck-off, though.
That's going to be it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to be it. Very good usage of just...
for a second, very lucky timing there. That was doable, but with the Astra suck, sort of... She needed to kill the Astra first.
That's correct, but Bui with the excellent timing with the Viper's Pit, just managing to just kind of skirt around the push there, and just catching them out one at a time. We do have another Sky Ult being popped.
Jet, you mean?
Oh yeah, just get Jet ult. Jet.
So confused the first time. I was like, "Wait, did she?"
Yeah,
maybe.
No, we do have a Jet ult popped now. There is the Astra ult also in play coming out from Sac State. So
Both sides.
Yeah, from both sides actually. Yeah.
Mill room is clear. And Spain isn't gonna see anybody in heaven. Vision. They know that heaven is basically clear. The question is, do they see Rose?
Do they? That's the real question.
Ooh, Krolos was seen by the ulting Jet.
They suspect. They are just continuing to smoke this.
And this Jet gets the knives. Ooh, saw Python, but isn't able to connect. And Sac State, I think, is going to be rotating to A here, Link.
I think so, too.
Ooh, Krolos is lurking, though, but so is Sage.
Whoa!
Oh!
Sage
huge
jump scare.
Huge by Krolos.
That is a definite Sage jump scare
seconds
there.
Left.
They are going to rotate.
Now it's 5v2.
Krolos on the top in heaven here. Catches the Jet ult out.
And now it's just a single Astra with a Sheriff.
Yeah. Don't you mean Viper?
Yes, sorry. I was looking at the... it looked vaguely like Astra. Oof.
And
there we go.
Is that... 7-1. Already, wow.
Yeah, I mean, this is about what we expected. Press World is going to do a timeout.
I think it's just to reevaluate where they are economically, because look at their credits. It's not looking very good.
I mean, it hasn't looked good for the last 7 rounds, I would say. I mean, there is a few rounds that they had to win if they had a chance, and unfortunately they did not. Again, if you look at the 1-7, really the only one was actually Sac State, just, you know, kind of walking into it. So once again, similarly to what we saw in the first map, Sac State kind of gives over rounds more than the other team takes them.
I agree. But the thing is, what do you think they could try to do to, like, get back in this, you know? Like, any ideas?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I think their best chance is probably just taking the gamble. Like they did that one round where they, unfortunately, the gamble didn't work out, where they chose A when it was B. But I think if they 5-stack a site, and hope that Sac State picks that one, I think the numbers advantage is going to be better than trying, you know, 3v5 or.
They are. Even it looks like they're going. Might be going for a B play here potentially. Viper's pit is deployed really early on in mid. I don't know why. That seems very. That seems like an interesting usage of the Viper's pit a bit early there.
Yeah, I mean it's one of those things where it's a Hail Mary, right? I mean, what can they do? They can cut off mid. Astrowall comes out by Sack State.
But about to enter. But the Viper's pit Krolos just. Ooh, that was a really nice play there from Krolos.
Ooh, but Spain doesn't know. That was a big shot by Blinks there. Wealth blinded was able to get Spain's head, but now it's just Blinks against the world.
But the spike is down on B, so now it's, yeah, it's quite, they're just against the world. But
Krolos.
Expecting it. There's got to be something they can do. There's got to be something they can try to do, at least to bring this back a little more.
Yeah, I mean, the only ult they have now at this point is the Astrowall, which can't really do too much on its own. I do kind of like that mid-Viper pit just because it was wacky. You know, if Saxate happened to pick mid,
we're getting an A rush. Right
there. We sure are.
They're using all their utility here.
Yeah, I mean, this is what they had to do. They have nothing to lose. Killjoy goes down.
That is going to be a big Killjoy. It's going to give a lot of advantage here to Sac State.
Yeah, Bowie gets
Presbro. It's going to catch two.
And everybody is in. Lynx gets Krolos with that Spectre. And Jet was detained there.
Managed to catch out the
slightly
Jet.
Slightly missed. And Python gets Rose. There are guns down.
There are guns, but both the Viper and the Jet are trying to walk Ooh. Through this office area here.
And that's it.
Yeah. They got really sectioned off there. That Killjoy ult was huge.
Yeah, I mean, you can really see sort of the skill disparity here. Even within Morningside, I mean, you got Helpless 0-10, Memo 10-10, and everybody else is negative. It's kind of when they're able to get Helpless every time, that they're always starting at a 5v4.
That's right. Memo holding close.
Memo gets one, gets Krolos. That's a big early pick.
That is correct, especially since the amount of value that Killjoy can bring with all of her utility.
Python.
Ooh, Python
got tagged.
Got a bit cheeky Ooh. There. The decay cannot kill you. It can get you really low, but it cannot kill you.
If they peaked that would have been a great peak, knowing that Viper wall was there. Sky is able to heal Python almost up and helpless.
Sky dog.
They know where he is, and now they're just gonna try to wallbang.
Yeah. It's just helpless here on B. I'm surprised none of the other members of Morningside.
Memo in heaven. Memo gets very low. Ooh, but Bowie.
They are gonna rotate.
Press doesn't know. Ooh.
Bowie. They are gonna Bowie rotate around. Bowie probably could have gone for a knife.
30 seconds left.
Bowie's too nice. Blinks! Ooh, Bowie sees Ooh. Him. Molly's moth.
The Sage is going. The Astro is going to place out another smoke here.
Ooh, Bowie hears him though.
Yeah, Bowie's going to try and go for the pick. Toxin screen down. Just timing.
You've got a plant.
10 seconds left.
Spike does go down on A with How to Feed and Python here. Bowie, nice flank from Bowie. Catches.
Ooh, but Helpless. Blinks. Helpless is one now. Remaining. Helpless got him.
He's actually two.
No, 1-10.
Oh, so I've got a pick. Get a pick earlier this.
Yeah,
segment.
He.
Oh.
No. Huh. No, he just.
I must be seeing things.
Yeah, I guess so. But Helpless says, I got my one. And that is actually a round for Morningside.
That is correct. It's now 2-9. The economy's looking a little bit better. Not very much better, but a little bit better. Sac State, though, still is overwhelmingly leading in terms of eco.
Yeah, of course. I mean, this is, like I said, what you kind of expect. Now, this is a mid-push. See, this type of thing, if they use the Viper Pit now, would have been crazy. But it's a gamble. It's just Astra alone blinks.
Nobody managed to see that Astra. Nobody managed to see that Astra. Oh my gosh!
Ooh, spike down!
I'm surprised Helpless hasn't rotated to try and help. We do see a jet rotating around a B, as the rest of Sac State seems to be going B as well.
You mean Rose?
Oh yeah, sorry.
Yeah. Well, Imprez is still camping A site here.
I am surprised that the rest of Morningside hasn't rotated. Has started to rotate now. Because now they know that Sac State is heading their way.
Man, that's the Viper Pit out.
They do have the Geeko ult, so.
Spike planted.
They could use that to get some really good information here.
Yeah, I mean they're going to have to.
It's all you, little homie.
There it is. Not a single person from the Geeko ult.
Last player standing.
Spain.
I love that you say Geeko.
Well, it's G-E-E-K.
No, it's no.
Is it
Gecko? G-E-K-K-O.
I thought it was G-E-E-K-O. That's why I kept saying Geeko.
No, it's
He's just...
I had to check.
Is
but
it?
But no, it's Gecko.
Okay, good. K-K-O. Alright, I stand corrected. But switching that would be hilarious if it's
Wait a second, hold on. Connor, didn't you say at the very beginning that you would be chiming in to correct my pronunciation of character?
Yeah, I did.
Anyway, all right, it's 10-2, Morningside, and I have to do something here. Sac State now defending. And it's gonna be an A push. Morningside probably gonna go for a really aggressive, fast push here. Looks like they dropped the spike for a second. Ooh. Sky able to see with that guiding light that there are people A. And they can hear him.
Immediately, Bowie is rotating around to come help at A. And Astra is the only person left on B, which actually is not a bad idea since Astra can smoke across the entire map, so you still
can't. Yeah, but Morningside, they're looking to start rotating, but Sac State.
They're just faster with the rotates, it looks like.
Yeah, the question is.
I don't think they are. I think they're sticking it at A. Look at it.
They thought about it. But Spain with the flashes. Is able to tell that no, it's a fake. Ooh, Krolos! I don't know what Krolos was doing.
I have no idea.
Krolos caught with his hand in his pocket. And that's gonna be Prezworld planting with his little buddy.
Yep. Ooh, Python managed to catch out Rose. It is now even in terms of numbers here.
Yeah, Bowie up in heaven.
Ooh, Helpless.
Helpless. 3-12 now. Out of feed, able to get Prezworld, and Helpless is very low up in heaven. Ooh, big shot by Memo. Wow. Yep.
They're not done yet. There's still at least 3 rounds left. So they're not done yet.
And we'll see. Sac State gonna keep their money up and allow Morningside to get half buys with full armor. If Morningside loses this, this is gonna be a big problem for them.
Especially in the long run, yeah. They are gonna, it looks like they're going mid here.
Yeah, they're doing a fast mid here. Bui falls back. And it's just how to feed alone. Python, though, able to get them on a shorty.
But the rest of Sac State still on the high ground here.
4v4.
We do also have Spain coming around where the Viper Wall is.
They hear Spain here.
Helpless,
gets Bui again!
Yep. And Krolos
now
as well.
Krolos alone.
Krolos in a 2v1 here. With a... Does he have a classic? Yeah, it's just a classic.
Yep.
If he can manage to catch...
Oh, they saw him.
Ooh, Memo. Oh. All's up to Spain. That's it.
Yeah, that was really good from Morningside, able to get that again. If they lost more than one gun there, it would have been the end of days for them. Sac State able to get a full buy, but if they lose this one, it might be over for them on this round.
Let's just wait and see what kind of shenanigans they're gonna try and pull here. They do have pretty much all rifles now, so all rifles and armor here.
This is gonna be fun.
Yeah,
so
again,
it's gonna really hurt.
Here.
Yeah. If they lose this,
or even
really
a couple
hurt.
Of guns there.
Yeah.
Rose. Alone.
With the amount of noise that they're making, I'm certain that Sac State already knows that there's a lot of people mid. Helpless and Memo rotating back around to go and try and push on the left side of B, as opposed to mid here.
Yeah, Spain, it's interesting.
They
Rose
still have both Spain and Krolos on A site here. I'm surprised they haven't rotated yet. Given the
They don't know, they haven't seen the spike yet. They don't know if it's a fake.
That is a very good point.
For all they know, Rose has the spike and is ready to jump on the moment she hears Sac State leaving. Spain is being very patient, and look, it pays off.
They're gonna Morningside rotate here.
Rotating to A. But the big question is, Helpless can Helpless catch any rotates here?
That is a big sky left. Flash there. It's Krolos.
Yeah, they know they're all A.
Krolos still on the... Ooh, Krolos got sought out.
Spike,
but
down
the
A.
Molly manages to catch out Press World.
Helpless.
Spain!
Last player standing.
Big swing back from Spain.
Yeah, unfortunately, that's gonna be...
10 seconds left.
That's gonna be it down. The spike down.
I think they're gonna try and save this Vandal.
Toxins going up.
Yeah, I mean, they were able to get two rifles off of Sac State, which is going to hurt a little bit, but they're still going to be able to at least half buy. And now we're back to a familiar sight, Morningside. Their credits are down, only Helpless.
But they did full buy, so that sort of makes sense.
Well, yeah, but full buying isn't always the best.
It isn't always the best plan, especially given Sac State could easily just swing this back if they managed to get even one of these guns off of them.
How to feed jiggle picking on B.
Right there.
Knows they're there at B. Sac State should start to roast
Memo
here. Memo able to get Bui. But Krolos catches Blink.
Ooh, Python managed to catch Memo out while he was smoke trailing there.
And that's guns. Sac State now, everybody left has full rifles. And suddenly this is a nightmare situation for Morningside. Press World still has the spike and is still looking at B, but Sac State has two on B ready for them. Python gets caught out.
Oh,
But Spike is down.
And how to feed.
Last now it's just Rose. Standing. Rose is very low with that Spike. And is gonna get shot here.
Nope. Just barely dodge it. But not for too long.
Interesting.
It's just a little, just angling. It was just rough. It is what it is.
Don't even stop that.
And that's 12-4.
They got one more round left.
Match point.
And as you can see, the full buy didn't do them well for their last round.
It did not.
They are not going to be able to buy really at all.
Yeah.
Which is why I said wasn't the best.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. It really wreaked havoc with their economy for this last round, especially since Python now has an op.
Get out of my way!
Yeah, and Python's...
Jet ult coming out, which it kind of makes sense. If you were relying on the jet ult to get value, it really doesn't make sense investing in her too much.
Yeah, my monster on the loose!
Yeah, monster is on the loose.
They're all on B, though.
It's the fast B. Oh! Krolos! Caught out using her ult.
Blink's rushing in with the stinger. And it's now down to a 3v3. How to feed. The Viper's pit is out. The Sky ult does come out.
Blocking vision. Knocking them.
Jet ult from Python here.
Yeah, it's out of speed, going very low, but able to get two.
Has to find the spike. There we go.
And finds that's gonna it. Be it. And that is it.
Yeah, that's gonna be it for map number one here. Sac State taking it by the
defenders,
taking
win.
It very, very handily there.
This is progress, my friends.
So move on to the next map, which is going to be, I believe. I wonder what the next map is going to be. I do not know that. We are going to go to a short break here while we sort out what the next map is going to be. Anything you want to say from that match, Corona?
No, I mean, it kind of shows you. I mean, Sac State only dropped two when they were attacking, and dropped two as well when they were defending. So it's almost like Sac State kind of has they're not really an attack or defense sided team. I think they're equally good at both holding and being very aggressive. So it's going to be hard for Morningside to try to exploit this and figure out what they're going to do for this next map.
I agree. We'll see you guys in a few minutes while they sort out the next map.
And we are back. This time, we are on Pearl, unfortunately. We're gonna be seeing a lot of B pushes down down long. And that's gonna be about it, probably. We're probably never gonna see A ever in our life, and
I don't know what you're talking about. A's a myth.
Yeah, well, you can't have B without A, but you also will never see A, so yeah I guess if you don't see it, then it doesn't
this
exist.
Is death math. This is just a deathmatch map. I don't know what you're talking about. There's only one site.
Might as well. This map is I would argue the worst map. The most boring map.
Well, enlighten me as to the reason why you don't like this map. Enlighten me.
Like I said, it's because there's really only one way to push when you're attacking. Down B. That's pretty much it. Just the way the map is designed, you really don't see much else in the higher ranks. So it's basically just who holds it longer, and it's a lot of just
who has the waiting. Better B push.
Yeah, and it's just, you know, who waits the longest. You can see three of them are gonna hold B here, or in fact, and just leave Killjoy alone on A.
Which, yeah, makes sense.
Yeah, but you know, that's
it is what it is.
Part of it. Yep.
Here.
All right.
Harbor wall.
Buoy on harbor, rather.
Yeah, they're gonna be going the back way. They're gonna be going the alleyway here. Looks like. That is a nice falcon there.
But nice memo, bird. Memo on the sheriff.
Are we actually seeing them rotate around? Are they actually going to A?
Nah, memo is able to get buoy.
Yeah. It looks like they actually are going A. Oh, nope, never mind. They're just DMing.
Yeah, I mean, I think they're trying. Ooh!
How to feed,
able to get memo.
Making it a 1-to-1 now. Krolos, getting
Killjoy gross. Be Killjoy.
Another really good falcon there. Wait, I keep saying falcon. Is it a falcon or is it just a bird?
It's just a bird. Guiding light, technically, I think is what it's called. And now it's just Sky on B. Able to tag Prez World a lot, but Spike is down on B. Luckily, Morningside did hear me and made it a little slightly more interesting before getting to B. Krolos going fast.
One enemy remaining.
Able to get Prez World. Well. And Blinks goes down as well.
Yep. As you call it, it's B.
Don't even start that shit here, mate.
I can't believe Sky just cursed on the stream. I can't believe it. We're gonna get canceled.
I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't hear anything.
It's PG. It's the one swear word of the stream. We're PG-13, guys.
All right, Sac State's spreading out a little bit more, and now it's a strong A push. Ooh, how to feed almost missed that bird there. But they see they're all A. It's a fast A push by Morningside.
Buoy, Buoy. Two.
Sprays him down. Spike goes down.
One enemy remaining.
Harbor bubble here to defuse.
Yeah, but it's
pretty much nothing that Viper can do unless.
That's gonna be a flawless. Yep.
So they tried to go A and it didn't work.
Yeah, as you can see, that's why you go B. There are just too many angles on A, and it never really goes well.
And they are heeding your advice, quite literally. They are literally all going B now.
Yeah, I think that was a really good read on Sac State's side. I think they got a little spooked by Morningside going through mid first, so they spread out far more.
But I think it's going to come back to bite him a little right here. Because now they're all just pushing one way. As Nemo managed to catch Python. Did Python have that off? I think he might have. Or he might have had at least a Marshall. I remember hearing.
No, it was a Marshall.
Yeah, because I heard a sniper shot. I didn't know if it was an off or not.
Yeah, he wouldn't have 4,000 credits if he had an op.
Yeah. Unless someone bought it for him.
Yeah, even then, though.
Another bird there.
Ooh,
that was a really nice wall bang.
Yeah, they heard him walk. Krolos gets Memo. Lynx gets Krolos.
They could just play. They could just play defensive here.
Yeah.
They're just playing for lineups at this point.
Shield going up.
Arbor bubble comes out again.
Is how to feed ready for Blinks. I don't think he is. He's
not. Neither was Bowie either.
Yeah, and Morningside able to get their one.
I got money. Need something?
They are going to have enough money to buy here. I think Memo is probably the only one who's struggling in terms of money here. Sac State is putting. Is doing a big gamble here, buying all rifles and an op. What do you think, Krona?
Yeah, I mean, at this point, Sac State's kind of gotta have to win this because of how much they've bought Python with the op. And Morningside going A.
Again?
Yeah.
That's surprising.
Spike is on A.
You think after what happened, they wouldn't try to do it again, but...
Yeah, but I think they're worried about Python.
Maybe they suspect he has an op already.
Yeah, I mean, if he had a Marshall last round, I would imagine that they would be expecting the op next.
Maybe they managed to calculate it based on the amount of money he had left.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Joke's Monster over! You're loose. Dead!
Phoenix ult two pushed. Ults.
Gecko ult as well. Both mollies are popped. Blinks has got nowhere to back up to.
Yeah. And Bowie gets Blinks.
Spike planted.
Spike goes down.
And Harbor ult. Harbor able to slow them off.
Right there.
They are
defusing
here. Sac State
is on. Memo getting buoy. They hear the op.
I do hear it.
They know where how to feed is as well.
Sac State's got to back up here. Try and play a bit more in angles. I think they ran out of time. Yeah, they ran out of time.
Yeah, at this point they want to save their money.
Save the op especially.
Yeah. That was a lot of guns to lose for Sac State there.
Yes, it is. It was a big gamble. It didn't pay off. And now Sac State's going to be reeling from it. They do have the op and a phantom, but the rest of them are going to be a bit sparse, so it's going to be really up to, like, picking a gun off the ground. Looks like Sac State is doing a timeout.
Yeah, I mean, I would say that's a good, solid timeout to do. 2-2 is kind of, I mean, Morningside looking way better on this map than Bind, or rather Split. It's the same. These maps are just, anyway. I don't have too much to say because we're barely going. But again, Sac State does have very little credits. They do have the op, but that's basically it. And Morningside has the ability to lose. a few and they'll still have credits for next round. So Sac State, if they're able to catch up on a few guns, pick up some guns from Morningside, it might be looking better. Sac State gonna do Killjoy A. This is a sort of aggressive push here. They're going through mid.
They're gonna get the orb.
Viper's there. So is Bowie.
Bowie is gonna try and go through connector here.
Ooh. Let's see whether Rose is ready. Ooh. Oh, they see her. Ooh! One big shot by Rose. But that's a Vandal down.
That is.
Bowie's able to get a Vandal now.
The op is still in play here alongside the Phantom. So it's basically three rifles now. Bomb is going down on A.
Spike planted.
We do have Blinks holding very aggressive here.
Ooh, but I don't... Oh, saw the barrel of the gun. Yep, and Python's able to get helpless there.
As how to feed gets Blinks.
One enemy remaining.
Python!
Yeah, and it's just Prezworld alone. They know where he is.
And
they catch him.
This seems to be a much closer game than the previous one.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's great to see. Sac State are able to get sort of a comeback now that they picked up a few guns.
Spain is still a little dry, but he got bought from his teammates, so.
What do you mean by dry?
All he had was a classic and 2,600 credits, but his teammates bought for him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Never heard someone called dry in that context before.
I mean, it makes sense because he was just dry on cash.
Dry on cash. Okay.
Yeah. It's a saying.
I believe you. Morningside going mid. But hey,
ooh,
two
Krolos.
Members of Sac State.
That was a really nice molly there from Krolos.
Placing swarm grenade. Out of charges.
Yeah, Sac State pushing from their spawn.
Every person of
how
they're all in mid. They are all in mid here.
Yeah, but Sac State going down 3v2, and now it's just the op.
You are divided.
And Spain, Astro Balls goes down.
Completely.
And that's gonna be A. Ooh, Spain able to get a cheeky one on Rose. But Spain.
Ooh, Spain. It's just the op now.
And now it's just the op, with an Astro Ball right there.
It's gonna come down. There we go.
Blocking sight.
Ooh. And that's
it. Yeah, and he's gonna be able to clean that up for Sac State.
Real good work there from Python with that op.
And the spray for good measure by Python.
The BM. Sorry, I'm just yawning a little bit.
Understandable. Valorant is resident sleeper. I do agree.
Yeah.
Give me more colors. Give me more voice lines. Give me more pings on my screen. Give me...
I'm sorry, our ADHD riddled brains are too used to Overwatch.
Well, yeah, it's just that's what Overwatch is, you know.
Yeah, ADHD Ooh. Simulator.
Blinks.
Ooh, memo.
That wall isn't gonna
Ooh,
stop.
That
Ooh,
that op.
Big shot.
Big shot from Python with the op.
And Python sees that there's more there. Question is, spike down
again.
By Python. And now Sac State knows the spike is down, and that's a flashed Python there, no problem.
Yeah.
That's gonna be a horrible push for Morningside. They know that op is there.
They have to walk into it.
Yeah, the moment that harbor wall goes down,
Viper's Ooh, and pit Viper as well. Pit get used. Just to guarantee that spike isn't going anywhere. I don't think that. Yeah. Actually, I think that might have been a little bit of a misplay. Now the op can't peek through.
I got the spike.
No, I mean Python was already rotating off. I think they conned for that to happen.
Fair point. And he's seems to be watching cross 30
seconds
here.
Left. Yeah. Yep.
Like that. There you go. And all that's left is helpless here. He is quite literally helpless.
Flawless.
And that's a flawless for Sac State. That is going to be big for their credits. They're looking pretty good at this point.
Yep.
And now it's Morningside who are down on the credits.
I think they're going to try and go for a bit of an eco here. But the problem with that is that, again, Python with the op. Doesn't matter what they buy. If he keeps hitting his shots, there's not much they can do. Waiting. There is the Viper lineup.
Out of feed knows that they're A. And Python now is actually on A. I don't think Morningside was expecting that at all. And now nobody's on B.
Except
if they're
the
smart, they heard the op on A. They should rotate to B now.
I'm surprised they haven't. We do see the Gecko out coming up alongside Phoenix ult as well. Op catching out the clone.
Ooh, Gecko's jumping around, and they smoke off Python now.
Dewey and feed and how to feed as well.
Yeah, Astra's looking for...
Sky's coming in alongside Harbor here.
Ooh, this could be really, really crazy for Python. He's getting pushed! And they got the op.
They did get the op, but...
Getting stunned out. Last player and Memo!
Using his own
right
Harbor,
on top of him.
Harbor bubble is against him there.
Yeah, and that's gonna be it, I think. Gonna be up to Bowie, but Bowie has two health and a dream. He's just hiding next to a box.
He's just gonna get out of there. Now this is not the best for Sac State at the moment because that op has now swapped sides. Although it's gonna they do have enough cash to buy another op. It's just that now there are two ops in play.
Yeah, I mean, the question is for Sac State, does Morningside have a good offer? I mean, Morningside has never really been in a position to buy an op in that last round, or really this one either. So the question becomes, who is Morningside's offer? And it looks like they gave it to Helpless.
And they are going to go all up rush A now, apparently.
Yeah, and Press World goes down.
Python's still on A. Kind of peeking a little bit.
You should run.
The Killjoy.
Attacker Killjoy comes out.
Double Killjoy here. Python is staying on this angle. He is not going anywhere. Just at the last end of it. Killjoy turret acting as a real deterrent.
And Jet just does have knives. Should she want to use them? But Morningside's gonna rotate off.
Kind of felt like they were stalling a bit there, but yeah, no, they are rotating now. But it really felt like they were just kind of stalling there for time and utility. They are all on mid.
40 seconds now for Morningside. They're all in mid, and Bowie is just jiggle picking long. Because they know that the op still exists, but actually nobody from Morningside has picked up that op by Prez World, so the op is out.
They are going to rotate back to A, looks like.
Yeah, and Bowie as well.
Viper's pit.
They're gonna have to use it. Somebody's gotta get Spike down.
Left. Going up. One enemy remaining.
And Python!
Blinks as well. Bowie managed to catch Blanks out. It's just Bowie pretty much against against three people here on A. See if he's able to catch anybody here. Ooh, just
yeah, he almost saw Rose's leg.
Almost. As soon as that Viper's pit goes down, that turret is gonna shoot him.
Yeah, but the Viper pit's gonna stay up as long as Viper's in it. Timing.
Timing, indeed. I don't think Bowie's gonna attempt to contest that Viper pit. I think he's just gonna try and save here. He did grab the op.
Bowie's gonna get the op. That's what he wants. And that's what he got. And that is actually a big grab by Bowie.
One op is now still in play here.
He's able to give it to Python. Do you think
they're gonna buy another op here? Do you think that? Nah, they're not gonna.
Who, Morningside?
Yeah, it didn't seem they didn't have enough credits to do it anyway.
And Morningside, I think, doesn't prefer the op, if I'm honest. I mean, even when they got a free one, we really didn't see. I think Helpless immediately dropped it for the sake of a Vandal.
I just think they're a bit more comfortable with rifles here.
Need that back.
Yeah, Morningside taking mid, but Viper, space.
Right there.
Viper ready. Is so is very Bowie. Sneaky here.
Ooh, how to feed. Ooh, got Spain, a little Spain, Spain. Juicy there, but Spain.
Ah, I only got one.
One.
Last player standing.
It's just Python here.
Just that... Python with the op.
They are all rushing. They're gonna go on site now.
I'm gonna bet the Python saves this op.
Spike planted.
Gonna try Thanks, and play wings. For picks here. Picks up a Vandal.
Yeah, that's probably the best thing. It looks like he wants to contest this. Ooh, but Will...
Timing.
I don't think he expects Gecko to be where he is.
I don't think he's gonna. I don't think he does. Python. Ooh. But both of them are. But I don't think they're gonna make it out. Are they gonna make it out?
They will.
Yep, just barely. Looks like we're gonna see some Stinger action here coming up from Sax 8. Three Stingers and two Sheriffs.
Yeah, I mean, Sac State on an eco here, and Morningside actually looking really good. 5-5, and Morningside has the money that Sac State doesn't. Sac State not even buying armor.
We're just gonna try and rush here.
And Python immediately got a fan to the face, and Helpless getting two.
It seems like. Yeah. Seems like Morningside is much more comfortable here on this map. Seems like they know how to play it.
Yeah, now it's just Spain and how to feed.
Ooh.
And they get mowed down. That's a flawless by Morningside. That is huge for Morningside. Now they're ahead last for the first time.
Yeah.
And we're at the last round of the half.
It's not looking very good for SAC in terms of their... But it doesn't really matter because it's last round of the half. I keep forgetting that.
Yeah, I mean, Saxate's not able to get full armor on two of their members, but
yeah, one of them has an op. So
this is true. But Saxate, for the first time, three of their members are in the negative. Though actually, Morningside, three of their members are in the negative. So that's kind of
double flash.
Oh, Memo
there.
Flashes himself.
Saxate's playing really far forward here.
Big flash by Sky. And Rose is the sole member.
Python's still just
mid.
Holding out here on B. Although Spike is A. This is just the biggest distraction.
You are divided!
Astrowall goes out.
Astrowall. Yep.
Yeah. Prez World planting.
Thanks, little man.
Spain gets blinks.
They are starting to defuse here.
And Smalley for Molly. Spain gets helpless, but Memo gets Spain.
Prez World uses his ult. Jekyll ult.
Ults are coming
not
out.
Not get anybody.
You're dead.
Again,
they know
Phoenix
that,
ult.
They know that ult is right on top.
Yeah, it's just the Phoenix left.
And Krollos defuses.
Switching sides.
And that's going to be a 6-6.
It's a very even game.
That is actually huge for Morningside. It's a big confidence boost, especially we briefly talked about it, but really didn't discuss it. From what we saw, I mean, Sac State has Ascendance and Immortals, and Morningside has some Diamonds and Ascendance. So, you know, there is a rank differential here. But I think Morningside, something has gotten into them, and they're looking way better.
I think this is their second win. What is... I'm trying Entire to understand
flash,
why you would walk
probably.
Out. Yeah, that makes sense, yeah.
Pull out.
How to feed, looking for anybody, but they can tell nobody's holding it.
They're holding
and
a bit
just
farther
Rose.
It's, yeah, it's just Rose. But now, but Rose with the comps. The rest of his team is going to show up here.
Found them. Bomb grenade. Lump up down.
Yeah, and
spamming
Krollos.
Through all of the walls here. Spike
Krollos
is going
might
down.
Krollos might catch out. Prez World.
Saxe is falling back from the site here. And just trying to play this long. Ooh, that was a very nice sheriff shot from Python there. Oh, Spain's playing for lineups.
And Krollos is in a very good position here. They don't expect it. Ooh, Memo, timing. Ooh, Krollos.
Last player standing. Oh, helpless
and
Prez World.
They go down. Sac State retaking it.
Unfortunately, this is not CSGO. There is not friendly fire. So Prez World just kept shooting his teammate when he was trying to shoot the enemy there. Imagine if Valorant had friendly fire. How hilarious would that be?
Cartoon game. Valorante. Children's game. Whatever that coffee pasta is.
I don't know that coffee pasta, so I don't know.
I couldn't tell you. It's something about Valorante. Children's game.
Valorant.
Alright, Sac State pushing long. They know that Morningside is not as comfortable holding these long spaces. Flash goes out.
Doesn't get anybody. Just barely missed both the Sac State, both of the members from Morningside here.
Yeah, Sac State a little nervous to get the turret. They
helpless,
see where Blinks
helpless,
is.
Helpless.
But do they see Helpless?
I do not think
they
do.
I don't think they do,
but
they swing enough. How to feed with an excellent swing there.
And it's just Memo left, pretty much.
Yeah, and they saw him.
And that's it.
And that's another flawless for Sac State. Yeah, I mean, I think it's really hard for Morningside when they don't have that sort of long sightline presence. That Sac State has with Python, you know, it's kind of really easy for Sac State to move through the map far quicker. And by the time they get to those short little angles, it's kind of too late.
Careful now.
Ooh, they hear the two mid.
I don't think they hear the two people on B here.
They do.
Python!
Yeah.
Real early here.
Do they expect Prez World, though?
Oh, Prez World!
Prez World gets two! And that's spike down.
That is a big swing. Now it is.
Yeah, Prez World.
Even.
I got the spike.
Grew some huevos there and pushed really far up, even when his teammate went down.
But Sac State now has another Vandal in play here.
Helpless gets Prolos. Now Rose is
here.
The only one left is the Astra on A here.
Yeah, Rose is alone here and they know where she is. She's gonna have to back up.
I'm surprised that Astra has not rotated.
One enemy remaining.
Ooh.
Didn't start to rotate until now.
Rose is able to get Spain.
Here.
Spike does go down though.
Yeah.
So Python
but
can just play closer.
It's just Python. And they know where he is. Diffuse starts. They spray the Diffuse.
Diffuse is half though.
All but that Blinks is not able.
Blinks is able to get it.
He thinks it's a fake. Oh, that was a... Ooh. Ooh.
That was a nice
That was
one
a
tap.
Nasty headshot though.
That was a nice
but
one
But it
tap,
doesn't
but...
matter. Doesn't matter. Python thought it was a fake, but pros never fake except when they do. But this time they didn't.
Pros never fake except when they
Yeah, pros actually fake a lot. But for some reason people say pros never fake, but they do. I mean, at the end of the day, Valorante Children's Game look to cartoon graphics to make kid player happy, like children's show Valorante Cartoon World with Rainbow, unlike Counter-Strike with Dark Corridor and Realistic Gun.
Alright, is that the copypasta?
Valorante like Playhouse, Valorant player run from CSGO, fear of dark world and realism. And Python gets on top.
Good bird there from Heat from Feed.
And Sac State's already on B.
Rose!
Sac State. Ooh, Rose! Gets buoy!
Spike has not been planted.
And sees where Rose is as well. Shoots through the smoke! Rose gets Python though. Spain gets Memo. And now it's just Rose on the back. Is vulnerable from that Molly. Krolos gets Rose. And Prezworld goes down as well. And Sac State is planting. Their money is looking good here. Python had max creds that time. And yeah, Morningside has to do a timeout. This is quickly falling away from Morningside.
I agree.
Boy, they were looking good for a little bit, but like I said, Sac State is just doing the strat that I was saying, straight down B, and the fact that they know that Morningside doesn't have as strong as a Marshall or... I mean, I don't even think Morningside has pulled out the Marshall once, let alone the op. Sac State is just kind of free to take B long and gets on the point, plants it, and that's it. So, I mean, this welcome to Pearl. This is what they do. This is what pros do, especially when they know that they are the stronger long angle holder.
Here.
Let's just see what's going to come out of this timeout. Maybe they're going to try and get back into that groove that they were in.
Here.
I am
here.
Cautiously optimistic. There's still a chance to swing this back, but Sac State has a lot of momentum here.
Yeah, I mean, if Morningside loses this right here, it's going to be over for them. And Sac State not doing what they've done before. You can see Morningside is kind of expecting Sac State on B. But Sac State's not going to do a fast hold. I think Sac State is kind of reading the timeout. They expect that maybe their coach has told them full hold B or something like that. So Sac State's playing differently for this timeout.
They're going to go... Looks like they're going to go A this time.
Yeah, but buoy.
Diaper
Pit goes out A.
Molly Bluey is activated.
Might catch this Viper
Blinks,
right here.
Blinks might is playing in the dugout here.
Buoy!
Buoy!
Timing!
I've got your trail.
Helpless got buoy there.
There is
he looks
the style.
Wrong way.
And now
oh,
Python!
Blinks
ooh
with an excellent read by Python. Python was crouching and perfectly found the head.
Still playing in this Viper's Pit.
One enemy. Yeah, remaining. And Viper's pit's about to go down, and Sack State suddenly.
They're gonna start.
Sack State's looking horrific now. All of a sudden, Morningside, that timeout, whatever flawless. They did in that timeout, they get a flawless.
Whatever that timeout was, it seems to have reinvigorated their spirits here.
Yeah, I mean, now all of a sudden it's switched. Now it's up to Sac State. They can't really afford to lose this one. Now, I mean, we're back to Morningside starting to get more momentum. Sac State leaving the spike in spawn. It's almost like they were confused as to who to take it. There were several that went back to look at it, but Jet Knives go out. And Sac State back to doing what they know they should.
Ultimate ready. Harbor ult is now online with that orb.
Yeah, that's right. Now there are still two on A.
But it seems like the spike is gonna stay B. It seems like this A push is a distraction.
Yeah. Yeah, and you can see the A starts to move. I think they're trying to get them to use some of their utilities. Memo could have the possibility here. Ooh, Jet gets detained mid ult.
That is rough.
Yeah, and Sac State crumbling here.
They gotta regroup. Seems like they may try push A. Keep the rest of Morningside at B while they push A.
Yeah, 30 seconds to go.
They gotta plant soon.
This is about to be
30 seconds left.
Harbor ult is used.
Wave crashing.
Yeah, Bowie goes in with that ult. Spain gets blinks. And now we're back 4v3 in Saxe's favor. Spain is pretty lit. Helpless. About to meet this 3 Sac State.
Nobody is on the site here.
Oh, Helpless gets Krolos. It's still 3v2.
It is still 3v2, but nobody is on the site. When it comes to that, Prez World. That was a wide peek there. Memo catching out Spain.
Yeah, and that's gonna be a wall bang. Not bad. Sac State. This is really going back and forth. Unlike that first map.
Indeed. It is getting a little hard to follow what's going on here, just because there's so much stuff going on.
Really?
No, I'm just joking. Oh. Viper's Pit is used on main here, or used on mid here, sorry, not main, mid. I don't really see the point of using
it. Ooh, Memo gets sprayed. They see Prez World.
Maybe to give the Viper a lurk opportunity here at mid?
Ooh, Krolos gets blinks.
They are gonna rotate over to A.
Blinks gets Spain.
Right there.
You Lockdown's gonna be used. And Rose is looking to use hers as well.
Rose catching out Bowie.
Targets destroyed. Yeah, but not ready for Python.
No, he's not.
Spike planted.
And now it's Prez World.
Ooh, Krolos
alone.
Catching
with very
helpless.
Little health.
Let's see.
Turret.
Ooh, that turret brought him pretty low.
18 health, Prez World.
18 health in a dream.
And Prez World is going to be saving this gun. But Python.
Not gonna let that. Ooh, Python!
Prez World! He's feeling good about that. Nice pick by that.
But they are gonna get the extra.
Ooh, Krolos.
Ooh, timing.
Wait, he didn't see it. He didn't see Krollos.
Timing. Good?
Hope so, hope
that
so.
Was why I think he was looking at his minimap.
I think so too.
Because he missed Krollos' little, yeah.
I think so too, but that was just very, very fortunate timing. On behalf of Press World there.
I will not lose my home again.
That is a cheeky little Viper spot right there. It's just right on the top of connector here.
Yeah, on Morningside, they are looking less for wear.
Well, Sac State's gonna go up B here.
Cabbages go out. Ooh, and Memo.
Memo
gets caught out by Python.
Krollos planting the spike here. Pressworld catching out how to feed.
4v3 at this point.
Ooh, Python.
4v2.
Well, to fight it.
Astral Wall comes out. I think Python wants to be on the right side of that wall.
Yeah, and it's just...
Whoa! Going. Helpless.
Helpless gets Python.
Last player standing.
Can Helpless do it?
That's the real question. There's playing. Ooh, manages just to get Krollos. But he's not going to have enough time.
No, and Bowie stops him as well.
But is he going to get out in time? Just barely, yeah, there. This is the decider here. If Sac State's able to take this, they will take the series. 2-0. What do you think the end result will be, Corona? Do you think that they'll try to pull something special out here, or just play it a bit more safe?
No, I mean, I think Sac State's probably just gonna pull it out, you know, main B. They know that Morningside doesn't have very good guns, so they can afford, the closer they get to them, the more likely that, you know, a judge or a Bucky could do some damage.
Do
so they're gonna try to stay away.
Well.
And they know people are there.
Killjoy ults. Killjoy's still sitting at mid.
They try to wallbang that screen, but nobody is there.
Walls up.
Harbor wall.
Ooh.
Spike down.
Memo's able to get the spike down.
Dropping fire. Set the spike.
Looks like they are going to plant here.
Hit a little bit.
There goes Harbor ult.
Yeah, and Helpless is going to get caught up in it. He's going to get caught up again.
Killjoy.
This is not looking good.
This is not. Saxate used a lot of utility there. They just gotta rotate around.
30 yeah, I mean, not
left.
Looking good for Morningside, I
Ooh,
mean.
Ooh, blinks.
Blink, what's the-
Oh my god!
Spike down A.
That was huge. That was huge.
Yeah, that's exactly what Blinks had to do with that judge. I mean, Saxstate just fell right into it. Nobody checked the corner. Saxstate getting too comfortable again. This is the second not checking your corner. And,
Balls up to Spain here.
Spain does get Blinks, but, I mean, doesn't do much there.
Yeah.
We're still match point.
We are.
Sac State has to buy though, and Python doesn't have any money.
Yeah, his teammates have quite a bit though, especially Spain.
Well, Python probably bought for somebody, I'm imagining, and is going to be using knives. But how to feed using that stinger, perhaps? I thought better of it.
I'm surprised that Spain hasn't bought a gun for how to feed.
Yeah, I mean, they might.
Maybe we're trying to pick a gun off of off of
I would imagine that's their plan. They're going mid, and look, Morningside was expecting that B push.
Prolos.
They are gonna start to rotate.
Very aggressive here.
Yeah, and they're gonna go aggressive A. Blinks is alone right there. But are they expecting Blinks? I don't think they will. Oh, they well, maybe Blinks wasn't expecting them. I didn't quite see how that
worked out.
But Rose,
he just walked into the smoke.
Ooh, buoy.
Ooh, Spain. Nice headshot there from Spain. And
that's
it.
Gonna be it on a flawless. Sac State taking both of their double headers. This time wasn't as swift as the first or the first map, but Sac State on their NECC Challengers group stage of the finals taking it very, very well.
Indeed, it was just a really good display of It was mainly what I thought was just a gun skill difference between the two. But I gotta admit, though, Morningside really gave them a run for their money, especially on Pearl.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, on Pearl, Sac State was kind of on the ropes quite a bit for many of those rounds. But ultimately, they were able to come up on top. I think, again, simply because of the lack of an Opera or a Marshall on the side of Morningside. But that's it. That's it for the day.
Yeah. Well, is there anything you want to say before we sign out for the night?
Yeah, I mean, Valorante Children's Game. Look to cartoon graphics to make kid player happy like children's show, you know. And Valorante Cartoon World, even, with Rainbow Unlike Counter-Strike. So.
Okay. I think we're done here. Thank you everybody for watching. Let's call it a night before you and I, Coretta, completely lose our sanities. Let's just go back to Overwatch.
Yeah, I need a even bigger child's game personally.
All right, guys. Well, we'll see you guys hopefully next time when Overwatch comes back on.
Yep. See you guys later.
Have a good night, guys.